Well, I'm from a little town north of the border called Toronto, Canada, and moved down to the United States in 1989. First job in the U.S. was at the CBS station in Miami, and then spent 14 years at the CBS network after that, and here I am at Fox. The first moment that I think I was interested really in what was going on in the world around me was when I saw Walter Cronkite covering the assassination of President Kennedy in 1963. And I was captivated by the images, and particularly that image of John Kennedy Jr., who was about the same age as I was, when his father's casket went by and he saluted as the funeral cortege passed. And then I watched Walter Cronkite all through the 1960s in the space race as America tried to put a man on the moon. And that really engendered in me a sense of fascination with the world around me. And while I might not have known it at the time, it really was kind of sowing the seeds of journalism within me. There are so many interesting stories that I've had the opportunity to cover. The Iraq War was tremendously interesting. The war between Israel and Hezbollah. So many disasters, natural, whether they be earthquakes or fires or hurricanes. I think probably the most interesting story that I covered was Hurricane Katrina in 2005, because there we saw a disaster and a response that was so pathetic that we had in America third world conditions. And you really have to scratch your head and wonder how that ever happened. And so to be in a place that is modern, it's such a hub of culture and art and diversity, and to see it really thrown back into an era in America that we haven't seen for decades. You might find it in many places around the world. Really was fascinating as a journalist to be right in the heart of it. There are so many places to go in this world when it comes to journalism. Who knew 2 months ago that North Africa was going to blow up and that we'd be on the cusp of civil war in Libya? You just never know. And I think that's a region of the world to really watch. What happens in the Arab world over the next few months, and potentially the next couple of years, could fundamentally reshape a lot of things in this world. You know, gas is headed north of $4 a gallon again. So what are the implications of that to our economy? The search for alternative fuels, the search for more energy efficient cars and other devices. You know, there are still a lot of stories to be told in this world, and I think we are just now seeing yet another paradigm shift, and it'll be very interesting to see how that shapes up. For more Fox News exclusives, log on to foxnewsinsider.com.